it all adds up to this is it for Jason Garrett. And I agree, it's two games. It's a wild card game and divisional round, get to the conference finals, or it's divisional round and conference championship and get to the Super Bowl. It's got to be markedly more than it has been in the past because the excuses are off the table. And I will tell you this. I'll tell you one more thing that's going on with Jerry Jones. I believe that people in New Orleans should be nervous. This is a play. It lines up for Sean Payton, and if not Sean Payton, Lincoln Riley. It will be all in on one of those two gentlemen next year in Dallas, and it might just line up perfectly for Sean Payton to come in and take the place of Jason Garrett.
Well, it's a trifecta because I don't disagree with either one of you guys. This is Jason Garrett's last year in Dallas. He will not be the head coach of Dallas for the 2020 season. The reason why is because he's not going to get to the conference finals, Will Cain. The Dallas Cowboys are not going to get to the conference finals. This disgusting, nauseating fan base that doesn't deserve anything but misery will continue to be miserable because you will come up short yet again. And that will be the end of Jason Garrett. Jerry Jones had an epiphany. If you recall, just a few weeks ago, he revealed that, you know, he didn't extend Jason Garrett. He's basically letting them know, yo, you got to get it done. I'm not getting any younger. I acknowledge the fact that I might be running out of time, all right, because I'm no young puppy anymore. And, you know, I've given you the assets that you need. You've got an elite defense. You've got an elite running back. You've got a quality quarterback. You've got a quality wideout, okay? The personnel around you is there. There is simply no excuse. And if I'm going to hold players accountable and everybody else accountable for getting the job done, when do I get to look at you? Now, we could sit up there and say, okay, it doesn't apply to him or it doesn't apply to Stephen Jones. But the reality is, I can't believe I'm saying this. I mean, it's almost like I've gone over to the dark side for crying out loud. But when you look at Jerry Jones and Stephen Jones, if you really, really think about it, they've done their job.
Yes.
Stephen Jones has compiled the personnel necessary, all right, for Jason Garrett not to have any excuses. I have no idea why all of this video is up while I'm talking. The camera's not on me at all. But that's a different story for another day.
I guess the
producers don't want people to see my face. But here's the point. All the personnel is there. The personnel is there. Jerry Jones, I can't believe I'm saying this, but Jerry Jones and Stephen Jones have done their job. It's Jason Garrett that has to do his job. And if he doesn't, Jerry Jones, I believe, has reached a point where this is the last chance for Jason Garrett.
Last piece of the puzzles, Will, does, like, you bring up Lincoln Riley and then quickly go to Sean Payton.
Yeah.
But to me, Lincoln Riley is so clearly the answer here. He has revolutionized the NFL from college. He has not yet coached there as a head coach. The Dallas Cowboys are the glamour franchise. They have everything you would think he would need. Why do you shift so quickly to Sean Payton? I would think you'd be all in Jerry Jones, better hire Lincoln Riley.
No, I'll be happy with either, trust me. And you could say it's because my bar has been lowered after 9 years of Jason Garrett. Or I do think that both are going to be probable successes in the NFL. But Sean Payton's track record is more proven. He's won in the NFL. He's won a Super Bowl. Lincoln Riley is still 2 to 3 years into his project at Oklahoma, and it looks impressive. But Sean Payton, and you add to that, by the way, his relationship already in Dallas, where you know that they can work together. Sean Payton and Jerry Jones have worked together already, and we know that's a requirement. We know that's part of the job description in Dallas. And Sean Payton, it just checks all the boxes.
I'm surprised at you. You're going the super conservative route. Maybe I shouldn't be surprised. But Lincoln Riley is the big imagination, big Dallas Cowboys kind of pick here over Sean Payton's.
I'd like to chime in here by saying this. I'm not sold on either of them. Let me explain.
Lincoln Riley
is the real deal on the offensive side of the ball. But when you're head coach, you're an overseer and responsible for a lot of things. And even though I know you could say you got your defensive personnel intact, that Oklahoma Sooners defense, by and large this season, was not very impressive. That's number one. All right, so I got trepidation. I'm not saying that it wouldn't be an upgrade from Jason Garrett. I'm not saying it would be a bad hire. I'm just not saying that I don't consider him the golden boy that all of y'all consider him. In college, yes. On a pro level, I mean, I just don't
know. That's rational skepticism. That's rational.
That's right. Now, with Sean Payton, here's my deal about Sean Payton. You've had Drew Brees all of these years. You ain't been back to the Super Bowl in 9 years. Yeah, Drew Brees. So I look at Sean Payton, and I'm like, excuse me, if I got a quarterback like Drew Brees, I mean, I'm expecting a little bit more. Do you understand that even Mike Tomlin has been to more Super Bowls with Big Ben Roethlisberger than Sean Payton was with Drew Brees? And I know Sean Payton's a damn good coach, don't get me wrong. But when are we going to talk about – there were years where he didn't even make the playoffs with Sean Payton as the head coach.
But the Cowboys have everything. Even if their quarterback isn't stellar, he's solid. But they don't have a real weakness when you look at the team.
That's right. So take this back full circle to what you said earlier, Stephen A., and this reminds me, we've had debates in the past. I think I debated you specifically, Max, on the job Jerry Jones has done. You know, whether or not Jerry Jones is a problem in Dallas. No, he's done his job. He and Stephen have put talent. They put talent. You know, the idea that Jerry's a meddler is kind of funny after 9 years of runway for Jason Garrett. He certainly had his opportunities. But they've got the talent. And Stephen A., when it comes to Sean Payton at various times in that tenure, he hasn't had a defense. He hasn't had the talent he's had over the last 2 years.
But he's the head coach. That's his fault,
but he doesn't have the same. He's not the GM in New Orleans. He's not the GM.
But you play a role. You're Sean Payton. You're a Super Bowl champion. You play a role in the personnel that's accumulated. I got to look at you in that regard. And as it pertains to Jerry Jones and Jason Garrett, even though I think Jerry Jones and Stephen Jones have clearly done their job, the one problem with Jerry Jones above all else, you could say his ego, but it's the fact that he holds on to a guy like Jason Garrett, whose only claim to fame is that he's loved by Jerry Jones. There's nothing else.